Welcome to edupediaworld.com. In today's video, we are going to learn about ecosystem. So what is ecosystem? Ecosystem is the environment around us. The environment is very vast and it consists of a lot of living as well as non-living, you know, organisms, certain gases, other substances which are organic and inorganic substances. So all this constitute together the ecosystem. Let's learn more about ecosystem now. An ecosystem, it consists of two words. One is eco and another is system, right? So eco means environment and system is it's a group of interactions where a lot of interactions are taking place. So in together, if we combine this term eco and system, it becomes that it's that environment where a lot of interactions are taking place. That is called as an ecosystem. And that is why I said this is the interaction between living, non-living organisms, between the nutrients, between the gases. So everything all together constitute an ecosystem, right? So the definition of an ecosystem is an ecosystem is all the organism living in a place together with their environment. Each ecosystem has its own living and non-living things, right? An ecosystem, you know, can be huge, such as large forest or an ocean or a desert, and it can be as small as, a small pond or a mud puddle or a single bush. You know, an ecosystem can be that small also. This word ecosystem was first given by A.G. Tansley in 1935, right? What have you understood by the definition of ecosystem? Ecosystem is an area, it's an environment where both the living as well as non-living organism, they interact with each other. So let us now talk about the parts of ecosystem. There are primarily two parts of an ecosystem. One is biotic part and another one is abiotic part. So what is biotic part? Biotic part consists of all the living things, all the living organism, like the plants, the animals, anything which is living will come under biotic. This will also consist of like producers, which are basically green plants, and consumers like animals and decomposers. So all three will come under biotic. As far as abiotic is concerned, abiotic means which are non-living, like the water, the gases, fire, anything physical which is existing, like you can see over here, ice, stones, or all these things are non-living things. So non-living things will come under abiotic. Ecosystem is basically there's an environment, and in an environment we have biotic, that is the living, and abiotic, that is non-living components interacting with each other. So this entire environment will be called as an ecosystem. So we have different kinds of ecosystem, like we have terrestrial ecosystem, we have marine ecosystem, desert ecosystem. So all these environments are different ecosystems. Ecosystems can be small as a pond or any bush can be an ecosystem, and it may be large like an ocean. So it may vary, the size may vary. It may be very small, it may be very big also. Let's talk more about ecosystem. So this is a kind of a grassland, and this is a huge, it's a very large ecosystem. It will have a lot of living organisms and also non-living things like the stones, the soil, the minerals and other inorganic and organic components which are available, the air, the water, the soil, so the stones, so all these will be non-living. So both living and non-living components. So it's very, very large. Ecosystem, as I said, can be like a small pond. Even in a pond, we will have, you know, living and non-living components together, interacting together, which will also constitute an ecosystem, right? Let's now talk about biotic and abiotic components. In biotic components, basically biotic components, as I said, will consist of living things. So living things can be like producers. So producers are like plants, so they are the primary producers, which these plants are also known as the autotrophs. Consumers and decomposers. So basically there are three major categories in biotic: producers, the consumers, and the decomposers. Producers, as I said, are plants, which are also known as autotrophs. Consumers are known as heterotrophs, and decomposers are like bacteria and fungi, right? So in the consumers can also be further divided into three categories, that is herbivorous, omnivorous, and carnivorous. So then word itself suggests, like, herbivorous means these are those consumers which consume only plants. They will not eat animals, you know. Omnivorous are those consumers which can eat plants as well as animals. So man is an omnivorous, you know, we are omnivorous because we eat animals also and we eat plants also. Carnivorous consumers are those which will eat only animals, you know, like lion, tiger. So these are carnivorous animals, right? Let's move ahead. Now we talk about abiotic components. Abiotic means non-living components, and these are also majorly of three types. One in which it is climatic factors. What are climatic factors? Anything exist, any factors, any change in climate, like rainfall. So that's a change. Rainfall, humidity, sunlight, pH, temperature, all these are climatic factors. So the first is climatic factors. Second is inorganic compounds, and third is organic compounds. So abiotic components can also be divided into three categories, that is climatic factors, inorganic compounds, and organic compounds. Climatic factor, we've already discussed. Inorganic compounds, like, these will include various cycles, like the carbon cycle, the nitrogen cycles, the hydrogen cycle, the sulfur cycle, the phosphorus cycle. All these cycles are available in our ecosystem. In almost all the ecosystems, some or the other cycle is available. So these are inorganic compounds. Like, now let's come to organic compounds. Organic compounds will have carbohydrates, the lipid molecules, and the proteins. So all these things, these three categories, will constitute abiotic components. And these biotic and abiotic components are present in almost every ecosystem. Let's also talk about types of ecosystem. As I said, there are various ecosystems available in the environment. Like, we have terrestrial ecosystem, the marine ecosystem, the desert ecosystem, the fresh water ecosystem. These ecosystems, they can be classified based on three different things, like three different conditions. One is based on nature, they can be classified. Secondly, based on duration, they can be classified. And third is based on size, they can be classified. So based on nature, they can be classified into two categories, that is natural and man-made. So natural ecosystem and man-made ecosystem. Natural ecosystem is an ecosystem which is naturally available in the environment. Like, we have the terrestrial ecosystem, which will include the grassland, the desert, and the forest ecosystem. Also, we have the second type of ecosystem, is the aquatic, in which, again, there are two types of ecosystem, that is marine, which is like ocean, the large water system. This is a salt water system, and freshwater system. So this is marine is a salt water system, and this is a freshwater system. So there are majorly two types of natural ecosystems, the terrestrial and aquatic. Next is based on the nature. Other types of ecosystems are man-made ecosystems. And what are man-made ecosystems? Like, we have aquariums at home, We have crop fields, we've seen crop fields also, and flower beds. So these are man-made, these are not natural. So these can also be an ecosystem. They're relatively smaller ecosystem as compared to the natural type of ecosystems, right? Now, based on the duration means whether they are available for a longer time or whether they are available for a shorter time. So whether they are temporary or whether they are permanent. So there are again two types of ecosystem, the temporary and the permanent ecosystem. Temporary will consist of rain-fed ponds. That is, these are those ecosystems which are only available for only some particular time or some particular seasons. Like during rains, the rain-fed ponds will become an ecosystem. Lab culture of microbes will also become a small ecosystem. Only in that lab, in that small container in which the species is being cultured. So that will become a small ecosystem, right? Next type of ecosystem is a permanent ecosystem, which these will be forest and lakes, and these are again a kind of natural ecosystems because it's permanently available. Okay, based on the size, we have small, or we can say micro ecosystem, and large, or we can say macro ecosystem. So small or micro ecosystems will be like flower pots, logs, some bushes. And the large, or we can say micro ecosystem, can be ocean and desert. So basically we are, you know, these things are getting repeated here. Like this is aquatic, this is again ocean. But then you have to understand whether it is a permanent ecosystem or a temporary ecosystem. Whether it is a small ecosystem or a large ecosystem, right? Or whether it is natural or it is man-made. So most of the natural ecosystems are permanent and they are large. They are large and they are permanent in nature. So these are the various types of ecosystems that are available in the environment. Now, in an ecosystem, what happens when the producers or the consumers or the decomposers, that is the biotic component, when they interact with abiotic component, in that environment, there is an energy which flows from the sometimes from the biotic to the abiotic, abiotic to biotic, and the energy flow takes place in the environment. So the energy flows from one component to the other component, right? So the primary producers, like the plants, so they, with the help of a process which is known as photosynthesis, they produce, they take in the carbon dioxide and they give out the oxygen, and with the help of the solar energy, they produce food. So they grow, they produce food, and these producers are consumed by the primary consumers over here. So in this process, what happens is a lot of oxygen is being given out and a lot of heat is being given out, and these primary producers become food for the primary consumers. Like over here, I have shown rabbits, right? Now these rabbits and rats, these are the primary consumers. They are further eaten by the decomposers. Decomposers are, as you can see here, these may be small worms or any other animals which are basically decomposers. So then what happens is these decomposers will be eating the primary consumers, and they will decompose this thing. After decomposing, they will release some of the inorganic nutrients in the atmosphere or in that environment or in that ecosystem wherever they are living. So now what happened, starting from the primary producers, the energy first was transferred to the primary consumers. After this, the energy was transferred to the decomposers, and after which again, you know, the energy was released out to the environment. From here again, the primary producers will be using this energy, which over here is inorganic nutrient, in order to reproduce with the help of even also the solar energy is a primary source of for their process, that is a photosynthesis. But they also use this inorganic and organic compounds which are released by the other consumers. In this entire process, the energy has been transferred from producers to consumers to decomposers and again back to consumers. So there's a flow of energy, this transfer of energy that is taking place in the ecosystem. Right? So now we will also talk about food web. Now, when this energy is transferred from one level to another level, from producers to consumers and then to the decomposers, what is this energy that is transferring? The energy is nothing but because one component is eating another component, the consumers are eating the producers. So they are eating, the primary producers become food for the consumers. So this becomes a chain, and this energy which is getting transferred is nothing but the food which is getting transferred. So this becomes a food chain. And that is why it is very important to talk about what is food chain and what is food web. In fact, these two topics we're going to talk in the next video. But over here, you should understand how the energy flow is taking place. So we talked about the producers, that is, those are the plants over here. Then we have the primary consumers, which are herbivorous animals, then the secondary consumers, then there may be another level in which we have tertiary consumers, and then the quaternary consumers. Sometimes in many ecosystems there may be just two stages, that is the producers and the primary consumers, and in some other ecosystem there may be three stages, it depends, and there may be four stages. But then this way, when the plants are eaten by the primary consumers, then the secondary consumers, this becomes food for the primary consumers. The primary consumers become food for the secondary consumers. And likewise, the energy is getting transferred. Right? So energy moves in the ecosystems through something called as food web or a food chain. Right? Energy is getting transferred onto levels after levels. One level to another level. Now, there are two things which you all should understand when we talk about ecosystem. Habitat. What is a habitat? A habitat is nothing but it is a place to live. In any place, wherever these animals and these living components and non-living components are staying or existing, these living components will always require some water to drink, some shelter to stay, some kind of nutrition. Right? So this such a place will become a habitat for these living components. Second term that we all should understand is a niche. What is a niche? Ecological niche is the role a species serves in its ecosystems, including what it eats, what eats it, and how it behaves. Right? So no two species will have the same ecology. Like depending on, and what is a niche? A niche is depending upon what a particular animal or a species is eating. And it is eaten by what all animals? How does it behave? How does it survive? How does it kill? So all these characteristics will define a particular kind of niche for that species. And always remember that no two species can occupy the same ecological niche. That is because one will fight with the other in order to stay in competition. Either one will, force the other one to move out of that area, to move out of his niche, and or he will just kill the other one in order to survive. And, he will make the other animal as a food for himself. So it is always survival of the fittest. So whichever is the fittest will survive. So that is why most of the time no two organisms can occupy the same niche. Right? Structure of an ecosystem generally consists of three important things. One is the physical structure. And how will we define the physical structure? What is the physical structure of an ecosystem? In an ecosystem, we'll have a biotic component. We have abiotic components and their interaction. And that will define the physical structure of an ecosystem. Because if there are many biotic components existing in an ecosystem and there are many abiotic components, then the size of the ecosystem will be large. Whereas, if there are very few of these, then the size of the ecosystem, the physical structure of the ecosystem will be very, very small. Right. Secondly, it is the species composition. Identification and enumeration of plants and animal species of an ecosystem will define what kind of ecosystem is it. So species composition is very, very important. What is stratification? It is nothing but it is vertical distribution of different species which are occupying different levels. That is called as stratification. Right? Sometimes there are 3 levels, sometimes there are 4 levels, sometimes there are just 2 levels in any ecosystem. So this vertical distribution of different species which are occupying different level is stratification. So these 3 characteristics are what defines a structure of any ecosystem. So hope you understood the concept of ecosystem and what are various types of ecosystem, and basically I've given you the introduction onto ecosystem. In the next video we will discuss about what are the functions of ecosystem and what are the threats to the ecosystem, how can we conserve our ecosystem, and then we'll move on to discussing the food chains and food web. So thank you for watching Edupedia World videos.